Christ, good to see each and every one how to assemble in the house of prayer.
Oh, yes.
Amen. Once again.
Oh, yes.
Amen. Before we get into the word of the Lord, amen, in the midst of our testimony service and praise service, one of our brothers, who's a no stranger here,
yes,
wanted to give something to the Lord.
Yes,
so before I go to the word of the Lord, allow him to do so.
Yes, Lord.
In Jesus' name. Put out your hands together for Brother Hayes in Jesus' name.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Praise him, praise him. Amen.
Thank you.
Yes.
The person that you see standing here, I don't know, you know, what perception you have on me, but I wasn't that way about 10 years ago.
Thank you.
You know, I wasn't calm. I wasn't thinking about God. You know, I had a lot of violence and anger. You know, still from time to time, I still do. But I don't have a violent part. But I still got, you know, the rage and sometimes.
Uh-huh. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
At that time, me and my fiance or girlfriend at the time, I'm not sure. Me and my wife, we was praying for the Holy Ghost together.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord.
Look to her, even when I need help.
Thank you, Jesus.
And I'm trying to get a good job, you know, have a kid, trying to get a good job, trying to supply, you know, provide for them. You know, Walmart was a good thing for me, because I didn't think I'd be able to, you know, get something like that. But I just thank God to stay here today to say that.
Amen.
Even the whole setup of how I was hired, but I'm not going to go through all that, but just a simple fact that when you're incarcerated, they instill in your mind, you know, you'll always be a felon, and you will never be able to work for the state government, anything. So you won't be able to have any type of good job, you won't have a career, you know, and being, even feel with the Holy Ghost, you get kind of discouraged. You're looking at all these kids, I'm about to have 5 kids, I'm always like right now, so I'm about to have 5 kids. You got cars, you know, you got cell phone bills, you got clothes, all this type of stuff. And, you know, I'm just kind of been down on myself. Like, man, like, this is a penny job, you know, the job that I was working at. You know, but I just thank God just for opening that door.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you. Let me know that, you know, that he's still God.
That's good. Yeah. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Wait a minute.
For those that have to mind on them. I just thank God just for encouragement. God, I'm
Thank you, Lord. Amen.
I'm not seeing a change in my children, but this one right here, he's standing in front of church and sing Jesus. You know, these two, the twins, they used to just always stand in front of church and just worship God. But I'm starting to see a like, little change. I know what's coming.
Yeah.
All of our children.
Yes.
Yeah. Yes.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God. Beautiful. Amen. Wonderful.
Thank the Lord for
yes, Lord.
Testimony coming.
Amen.
Brother Hayes, it's good to see him and his wife.
Amen.
Once again, in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We thank God for all that the Lord is doing.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. We serve a good God. And we serve a merciful God. We serve a God that keeps making ways out of no way.
No way.
Amen. So we give God the glory, we give God the honor, and we give him all of the praise. Amen. We're not going to be before you too long. We're going to get what thus saith the Lord and we're getting out of the way. All right. And we're going to find ourselves in 2 Kings. Amen. Find ourselves in 2 Kings. Find ourselves in 2 Kings.
Amen.
So in the second chapter, amen. I just want to thank the Lord for all that the Lord has spoken and all that the Lord has been manifesting and revealing to us through his word.
Yes, Lord.
Amen. As we state, the Lord has been speaking for quite a few months now. And we've seen the awesome manifestations. Amen. We've seen the awesome manifestations of what the Lord has spoken. Amen. And we thank God for it. So we thank the Lord for just his mouth and how that he feeds the men of God, the word of God, in order that he may give it to the people of God. And the word of the Lord tells us on numerous occasions as he gives us instructions about the last days. And in one passage of scriptures he said, in the last days, and individuals would depart from the faith. And they would begin to give heed to seducing spirits and doctrines of devils. And it tells us that before the coming of the Lord, before the Lord could come, there must be a great falling away. Amen. And so we know through the word of the Lord that there are things that must transpire. Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. There's things that have to happen. Things that the word of the Lord has spoken, and God cannot lie.
Amen.
Men and women lie, but God cannot lie. And there's one thing that is impossible for God, and it's impossible for God to lie.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. So if God has spoken it, it must come to pass. Amen. If God has decreed it, it's going to happen. If God has sanctioned it, no man can turn it around. Amen. It'll come to a point where even the prayers of the saints can't turn it around. Amen. Some things God would tell us. He said, don't even pray for these people.
Amen.
He would tell us, just get off your knees, stop asking me, because I'm not turning it around. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So when God speaks something, when God decrees something, and you fall into the hands of God, that's it.
Amen.
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 That's it. And so we're looking at the world and we see how the world has become desperately wicked. And it's all the fulfillment and the plan of God. Amen. But while the world is becoming desperately wicked, the people of God should become more closer,
amen,
more
amen,
spiritual, more sound,
amen,
when it comes to the word of God. And y'all know here, there ain't nothing new. Y'all know here, we've been warring for the past couple of months.
That's right.
Amen. We made it our business to war against that enemy.
Amen.
Amen. Talk back to me.
Amen.
Amen. We've been warring against the enemy.
That's right.
And we got to war against the enemy because the enemy is looking to conquer the souls of the people.
Amen.
Amen. He's looking to conquer the souls of the people. And for so long, we've let the enemy, we've sat down and we've let the enemy wreak havoc in our lives, in our homes,
Amen.
In our jobs, in our minds, in our children.
Amen.
And we refuse to get up and fight that enemy.
Amen.
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 This is his time for us to get up and fight him.
That's right.
It all you got. You can't have my
That's
mind.
Right. Amen.
Praise God. Amen. You cannot have my home.
Amen.
You cannot have my children.
That's right.
You cannot have nothing that belongs to me that
That's
belongs
right.
to God.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We got to get up and we got to fight that devil.
Yes.
Amen. And,
Amen.
And there is a spiritual shift.
Oh, yes.
There's a spiritual shift that has taken place within the church.
Uh-huh.
Because there's a shift that is taken in the world.
Mm-hmm.
And when the world shifts, the church got to shift.
Got to.
Amen. Are y'all hearing me?
Yes,
Pay
yes.
Pay attention. Listen, because some of y'all distracted.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Amen. Get your minds on the word of God.
Yes, sir.
Amen. Amen. When that world shifts, the church got to shift.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
The church has to shift. Amen. We serve a God that changeth not.
Mm-hmm.
God never changes. His word never changes.
Never.
But the power of God changes.
Hey.
The glory of God changes.
Yes, it does.
There are things about God that do change.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And we're going to see within the word of the Lord that how when the world shifts, there must be a shift in the church. 2 Kings, the second chapter, and let us begin at the first verse.
Amen. 2 Kings, the second chapter.
Yes, sir.
Verse 1. And it came to pass, when the Lord would take up Elisha into heaven by a whirlwind, that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal. And Elijah said unto Elisha, tarry here, I pray thee, for the Lord hath sent me to Bethel.
Now I want you to pay attention to something. And it said, and it came to pass when the Lord would take up Elijah into heaven by a whirlwind, that Elijah went with Elisha from Gilgal.
Mm-hmm.
All right?
Yes.
And the word of the Lord said that when the Lord would take up Elijah,
uh-huh.
which means the Lord is about to do something.
Yes.
God is about to move.
Yes.
Amen. God is about to take up Elijah. God is about to move.
Yes.
And so because God is about to move and God is about to do something, God is about to prepare his people for what he's about to do.
Amen.
Verse number 2 says what, brother?
And Elijah said unto Elisha.
Elijah said unto Elisha.
Tarry here.
Stay here.
I pray thee.
I pray you.
For the Lord hath sent me to Bethel.
For the Lord hath sent me to Bethel.
And Elisha said unto him.
Now Elisha is going to reply to Elijah.
As the Lord liveth.
He said, as the Lord liveth.
Uh-huh.
And as thy soul liveth.
As thy soul liveth.
I will not leave thee.
I will not leave thee.
So they went down.
God's about to do something.
Uh-huh.
God is about to shake up some stuff. God has a plan to remove Elijah out of the way. And he got to prepare his prophet for what he's about to do.
That's right.
So Elisha,
yes.
even in spite of the instruction that Elijah has given him, you stay here.
Amen.
God is sending me somewhere. Elijah has a determination within his mind. I'm not leaving you. Amen. No matter what. Are y'all reading the same Bible we're reading?
Uh-huh.
Amen. And the word of the Lord said what?
So they went down to Bethel.
So Elisha goes with Elijah down to Bethel.
Amen. And the sons of the prophets.
And the sons of the prophets.
That were at Bethel.
That were at Bethel.
Came forth to Elisha.
Came forth to Elisha.
And said unto him.
And said unto him.
Knowest thou that the Lord will take away thy master?
Do you not know that the Lord is getting ready to take away Elijah?
From thy head today.
From thy head today.
And he said.
And he said.
Yea.
Yes, I know.
Hold ye your peace.
Hold your peace.
And Elijah said unto him.
And Elijah said unto him.
Elisha.
Elisha.
Tarry here.
Tarry here.
I pray thee.
I pray thee.
For the Lord has sent me.
For the Lord has sent me.
To Jericho.
To Jericho.
And he said.
Now notice Elijah wants Elisha to stay. He does not want Elisha to go with him. Elijah knows that God is about to remove him off of the city. And he does not want Elisha to witness it. So he tells him, stay here. I'm going to Jericho. But what happens?
And he said.
And he said.
As the Lord liveth.
As the Lord liveth.
And as thy soul
liveth. As thy soul liveth.
I will not leave thee.
I will not leave thee.
Yes. Amen.
And so.
They came to Jericho.
They came to Jericho.
And the sons of the prophets.
And the sons of the prophets.
That were at Jericho.
That were at Jericho.
Came to Elisha.
Came to Elisha.
And said unto him.
And said unto him again.
Knowest thou?
Don't you know?
That the Lord will take away thy master.
The Lord is going to take away thy master.
From thy head today.
From thy head today.
And he answered.
And he answered.
Yea.
Yes.
I know it.
I know it.
Hold you your peace.
Hold your peace. And what happened?
And Elijah said unto him.
And Elijah said unto him.
Tarry.
Tarry.
I pray you.
I pray you.
Here.
Here.
For the Lord has sent me to Jericho.
For the Lord has sent me
to Jordan.
To Jordan.
And he said.
And he said.
As the Lord liveth.
As the Lord liveth.
And as thy soul liveth.
As thy soul liveth.
I will not leave
thee. I will not leave thee.
And they two went on.
And they two went on. Elisha had a determination that he would not leave Elijah's side. And we're going to see what's going to happen.
Yes.
And the word of the Lord said, what, brother?
And 50 men.
And 50 men.
Of the sons of the prophets went.
The sons of the prophets went.
And stood to view afar off.
And they stood to go view afar off.
And they too stood by Jordan.
And they too stood by Jordan.
And Elijah took his mantle.
All right. I want y'all to pay attention to something.
Uh-huh.
Elijah takes his mantle. Elijah takes his mantle.
And wrap it together.
A mantle is something similar to a robe. But a mantle would be more like a shawl. A long shawl that a woman would put on. Because it didn't close up, threw it over you. It was loose. It wasn't like a roll where you stepped into it and put your arms in it. It was a sheet, a blanket of some sort, and that you would robe yourself with it. So Elijah grabs his mantle
and wrapped it together.
He wraps it together
and smote the water.
And he smites the water.
And they were divided.
And the water was divided.
Hither and thither.
This is the second incident.
Uh-huh.
But the water has been divided.
Uh-huh.
The first incident took place when Moses was bringing the children of Israel out of Egypt.
Yes.
And the water was divided. The next time we see in the scripture the water being divided is here in this scripture where Elijah takes his mantle and parts the water.
Uh-huh.
And the word of the Lord said what?
So that they too went over on dry ground.
So they walked on dry ground.
Amen.
Verse number 9.
And it came to pass.
And it came to pass.
When they were gone over.
That they were gone over.
That Elijah said unto Elisha.
That Elijah said unto Elisha.
Uh-huh. Ask what I shall do for thee.
He knew that Elisha was determined to follow him at all costs for a reason.
Uh-huh.
Regardless of when, he would tell him, you stay here. Elisha was determined to follow Elijah at all costs.
Uh-huh.
So Elijah looks at Elisha and says, what do you want from me?
Mm.
What can I do for you?
Mm-hmm.
And the word of the Lord said,
What shall I do for thee?
What shall I do for you?
Before I be taken away from
you. Before I be taken away from you.
And Elisha said.
And Elisha said.
I pray thee.
I pray thee.
Let a double portion.
Let a double portion.
Of thy spirit.
Of thy spirit.
Be upon me.
Be upon me.
Yes, Lord.
And the word of the Lord said what?
And he said.
And he said.
Thou hast asked.
Thou hast asked.
A hard thing.
A hard thing.
Nevertheless, if thou see me,
uh-huh.
I am taken from thee.
I'm taken up from thee.
It shall be so.
It shall be so
unto thee.
Unto thee.
But if not,
uh-huh.
It shall not be so.
It shall not be so. Many times we ask God for things.
Uh-huh.
We ask God for stuff, and then God will give us instructions on what we got to do in order to do it.
Amen. Amen.
In order to get it. Then when he gives us the instructions, sometimes we don't want to do what the Lord told us to do.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Sometimes we don't want to do.
Amen.
What he told us to do. But in order to get what it is that we've asked of God, we've got to be obedient to the instructions of God.
Amen.
Or we won't get it.
Amen.
Is that all right?
That's right.
When Jesus brought, when this man brought his son to the disciples of Jesus, and they could not cast out the evil spirit that this child had, Jesus tells him, this only comes out by prayer and fasting. Gives us the remedy. For what you got to do in order to get it out.
Amen.
Then people don't want to pray and fast.
Amen. Amen.
And wonder why they can't cast out devils.
Amen.
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 Wonder why the world is in the condition that it's in and things don't change around us.
Amen.
Jesus said, if my people, which are called by my name,
uh-huh.
will humble themselves,
that's
pray,
right.
seek my face, turn from their wicked ways, then will they hear from heaven. God gives us instructions,
uh-huh.
precise instructions,
amen.
in order to get the job done. Amen.
Amen.
Many times we don't want to follow the instructions of God.
Yes.
So Elijah tells Elisha, if you are there when I'm taken up, then you can receive
yes.
the double portion of my spirit.
Yes.
But if you're not there,
shall not be so.
It shall not be so.
Mm-hmm.
So now it gives Elisha even more of a determination to follow Elijah even the more.
That's right.
He already had a determination.
That's right.
Elijah told him, don't go. And Elijah said, as my soul liveth, I'm going.
Yep.
As long as you're alive, I'm going.
That's right.
As long as you're here, I'm going.
That's right. Right there with you.
I'm going.
Uh-huh.
Now, this gives Elisha even more of a determination not to leave Elijah.
Amen.
And the word of the Lord said what, brother?
And it came to pass.
And it came to pass.
As they still went on.
As they went on.
And talked.
And they were talking.
That behold. There appeared. A chariot of fire. And horses of fire.
And parted them both asunder. both asunder.
And Elijah went up.
And Elijah went up.
Hey.
By a whirlwind.
Into heaven.
Into heaven.
Yes.
And the word of the Lord said what?
And Elisha saw.
And Elisha was there.
Uh-huh.
And he cried.
And he cried.
My father.
My father.
My father.
My father.
Chariot of Israel.
The chariot of Israel.
Jesus.
And the horsemen thereof.
And the horsemen thereof.
And he saw him.
And he saw him.
No more.
No more. Now I want to show you something.
Uh-huh.
When he cried, my father, my father, he was not talking about God.
Yes. Uh-huh. That's right. Amen.
Praise the name
Amen.
Of the Lord. When he cried, my father, he was not talking about God.
Amen.
Thank you, brothers. He was talking about Elijah.
Amen.
Elijah was Elisha's spiritual father.
Amen.
He trained Elisha. Elijah was a prophet.
Uh-huh.
And Elisha was a prophet.
Amen.
That studied under the cloak of Elijah.
Uh-huh.
So when the angels of the Lord, the chariots come and take him away, he cries, my father, my father.
Yeah. Hey.
Chariots. Because now his father has been taken away.
Uh-huh.
But watch what takes place.
Jesus.
In the midst of him
uh-huh.
saying that. And the word of the Lord said, what, brother?
And he saw him no more.
And he saw him no more.
And he took hold.
And he took hold.
Of his own clothes.
Of his own clothes.
And rent them.
And rent them.
Into pieces.
Into pieces.
Amen.
Now in the scripture, the renting of the garment represented sorrow.
Amen.
It represented humility.
Yes.
It represented the humbling of oneself.
Mm-hmm.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Whenever you find the scripture where their clothes were rent,
mm-hmm.
it was because they felt sorry.
Yes.
And they humbled themselves.
Amen.
And then they would put on sackcloth and ashes. In order to cry out to God for whatever it was that they needed from the Lord.
Yes.
So now what takes place as we look past the surface of the scripture.
Uh-huh.
Elisha rips his own clothes.
Amen.
And he gonna do what, brother?
And rent them in two.
He rent his clothes in two.
And took up also.
Uh-oh. And he took up something.
Yes, sir.
He rips up one thing.
Yes.
And picks up another.
Jesus. Hey.
Y'all with me?
Yes, yes.
In order to walk this way, there must be self-denial.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
You've got to deny self.
Got to.
Yes.
Got to be self-denial. Elijah has been taken into heaven. And Elisha is going to rip his own
uh-huh.
clothes.
Uh-huh.
Y'all pay attention to the word, not what I'm on it though.
Uh-huh.
Amen.
Go ahead.
Amen.
Y'all get too distracted.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Some of y'all act like children, like you can't pay attention, like you can't ignore.
Yes,
amen.
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 He ripped his own clothing
into